forests and vegetation and all that great stuff that we get to see out here today, and that's why they gave it the name the Garden Isle. They say it is the most beautiful of the Hawaiian Islands.
Sounds like thunder, gotta head for the high ground. White water coming, no fooling around.
Alright, so we're coming up on the north shot ahead of us here. You can see that first point off in the distance. That's Ka Beach, also known as the end of the road. So that's where the road ends and the trail begins up here on the north shore of the island. And what you can do, and what most people do, is the first 2 miles of the trail, 2 miles in, 2 miles out, would take you to this little beach off the left, which is the Hanakapiai Beach. That first stretch there, that's got to be the most popular hike around the island. You can do an additional 2+ miles to the back of the valley to there. That's the Hanakapiai Falls. Looking at closer to 9 miles round trip. But again, it's going to be closed for a while, but you get a good look at it there. I'm going to take you around the corner here fast. So you got Hanakapiai, Ka, you'll see Tunnels Beach and Tunnels Reef coming into view, and I'm going to take you over the Tunnels Beach and Tunnels Reef. We're going to climb up, circle back around, and get you some fun views of the North Shore and the reefs and the waves from up top. But one of my favorites, for sure, especially on a beautiful day like today, is looking back down the Napali here behind us from up north, a little bit closer to the Tunnels Reef here.
Like the crab on the rock, you gotta run real fast.
Gotta run, you gotta go right now.
Keep your eye on the wind, don't never turn your back.
Man, grab your bank and run.
Oh, B-Man, another swell's coming your way.
Oh, B-Man, another swell's coming your way.
Okay, Beach, so you see the lagoons on the inside there, so Kay and Tulls, these have become really popular for swimming and snorkeling. So normally you see 100, 200 plus people down here on these beaches. You just can't get down here right now. And there's Tunnels Beach, Tunnels Reef. I'll circle back around once you get a little bit closer there.
White water coming, no fooling around.
O-P-Man
in the sun.
O-P-Man, grab your bag and run.
O-P-Man, another swell's coming your way.
Another swell's coming your way.
B-Man, another swell's coming your way.
This is the life.
For you to be right there. It's one of my favorites for sure, especially as you get Tunnels Reef back into view there. All the blues of the reef I got. Getting any nicer than this. It's been a really wet year so far, so days like this, sir, we love them.
When I want to go up and sit right down and look at the ocean so blue, I want to feel the breeze blowing in my face and let all things hang loose. Whisper your name, feel no pain, relax and cruise. This is the life I was given. This is the life I love country living. This is the life meant for me and you. So
I hope you get to live it too.
Now, this is all the North Shore that we're looking at out ahead of us here, what we generally refer to as the Rainier or the wet side. So the Hawaiian Islands, we sit right under the trade wind belt. So the trade winds are blowing out of the northeast over 300 days out of the year, and that's what they'll generally bring or build the wet weather with it on this side of the island. Mountains can keep it over here. We'll end up getting most of the rain, about 80 inches of rain down here on the North Shore, only about 20 on the South and West Shore. So there's definitely a little bit of a difference there in rainfall as you make your way around the island. And with the flooding which occurred recently, so they're now saying it was over 50 inches of rain in 2 days on the North Shore. That's over half of our annual rainfall in less than 48 hours. And we're going to head back on shore here over to Lumai Beach in front of the Big Bay there. I need to allow it. It's the one and only Hanalei Bay, which is pretty much the heart of the North Shore. And that's just because everybody really loves Hanalei. Nice beaches, fun surf, good food, good people. Very laid back part of the island. And to the left there above Hanalei on the sea cliffs is Princeville, the little resort community. The biggest one on the ridge there is the St. Regis Basin House, which is a great spot to watch the sunset. They got really good ginger margaritas. And that's where I was for the hurricane. I was in there, I was 7 years old. The furthest point off in the distance is Kilauea, which is the northernmost point of the island. And that's where the Kilauea Lighthouse is. You can see it from here. We're going to follow the ridge right towards the back of Hanalei, back over into the Hanalei Valley here. Nice view to be out the left-hand side there, looking towards the shoreline. Then from the shoreline, looking Mauka, which always means towards the mountains, you're going to see three peaks over here on the right. The tallest of the three is going to be the one in the middle, just over 4,000 feet tall. You're going to see Mount Mamulokama. Same peaks and waterfalls you get to see from the road down here in Hanalei and Princeville, but I'm going to do one better here for you since we're up here in a helicopter and all. And all these bear marks you see down the cliff sides are all this dirt. These are all landslides, fresh landslides from the flooding. Down the ridge here, we'll do a turn out here. Everybody can get a nice view and picture of the Hanalei Bay from the Mauka side here. I've never done it, but there's a hike. See where that tree sticks off that point there? There's a little hike, probably a pretty gnarly hike that takes you right to that tree. You'll see there's some flags hung up underneath it there. most people only do half to that lower portion of the ridgeline. But I have seen people up there. Flags hung up in there. Just crossing back over the Honolulu River Valley here. Probably gonna recognize this area. So we followed this one, that's the volcano back over there. Still a few minutes out, we're headed back towards the shoreline. We're gonna be riding over there in Princeville in a few, and we're not quite there yet. So I will let you know when it's okay to take off your headsets and your seatbelts, which is gonna be after you land. And then please sit tight for me. We gotta wait for the ground crew. They're gonna come get the doors for us. So watch your step, watch your head on the way out. It's very important that you always head towards the front of the helicopter. But other than that, tell you what, you couldn't ask for a nicer day. Beautiful afternoon there in paradise. And hope you guys had a good time. I know I sure did. Been pleasure having you here with us. And hope you enjoy the rest of your trip here in the Hawaiian Islands. We're turning back to the ramp over to the right here, but we're going to be landing very shortly, and it's been fun. Thanks again, everybody. If there's anything else, just let me know right here at the helicopter. I appreciate it.
You can save me now, but I've been lost in my own place, and I'm getting weary. How far is heaven? And I know that I need to change my ways of living. How far is heaven? Lord, can you tell me? I've been locked up way too long in this crazy.
Yeah, not bad for my first time, huh? Nah, just joking. Glad you guys had fun. I had fun too. You can take off your headsets and seatbelts. We'll be out to get the doors for us.
And just keep on living. How far is hell?
Yeah, I look at it.
Yeah, thanks again, everybody.